What is power building? Hey everybody, I thought I would chat with you guys and gals a little bit about this today. This is one of these terms that I've started using more and more. I used to kind of joke and say, well, it's a term that means nothing, so therefore it can mean anything that you want. But I feel like it's something quite a few more advanced lifters over the years have embraced more of a concept, and I feel like we can define it a little bit better now, and it's something I've really started incorporating more of, because I realized a lot of my training styles that I coach and everything almost fell into that. And so I've kind of refined it more as I've gotten into training for physique instead of just powerlifting. And I've noticed, again, other lifters who do it, there seems to be some common themes. And here's what I would say: power building, really, if you want to think about it, is combining a small element of powerlifting into bodybuilding. So if you heard people like Michael Hearn call it power bodybuilding and stuff, and that's what he does, essentially what it would be in that case is a bodybuilder split, right? Training on a normal bodybuilder split, but at the start of some of your workouts, doing some heavy work in the 1 to 3 rep range on classic lifts, like the classic power lifts or close variations of them. They could be, obviously, they could be things like box squats or whatever, or even an incline bench or reverse bench, things like that. But we could argue that the reverse bench is still a bench, isn't it? Because federations allow you to do it. There are powerlifting federations that absolutely allow the reverse grip bench in competition. Keeping in mind, first guy to ever bench press over 600 pounds did it with a reverse grip. Okay? Right? You guys remember that? So I wouldn't even rule that out. Same thing, we could talk about the box squats, but the West Side guys train almost exclusively on a box. They only really do a free squat in competition. There's a whole lot of that. So if they're doing variations like that, I don't think it's necessarily a problem for this, right? Perfectly reasonable. So what I would define then as power building is if over 90% of your training is really just a bodybuilding split and 10% or less is focused upon heavy work with the big three. Now, what I wouldn't call power building is when people say, well, I'm doing heavy fives or sixes or whatever on some of those lifts at the start. No, that's definitely not power building, and here's why. Because it's not powerlifting training. That would be a possibly off-season, maybe hypertrophy work for some powerlifters. Because the problem with that idea is fives is just really not that heavy, right? If you can do 3 sets of 5 with a weight, and again, I know to people who train purely bodybuilding, that sounds crazy. But for those of us who come from a strength athlete background, it's like, dude, if you can do 3 sets of 5, that's moderate weight. That's not even that heavy. That's probably 80% of your max. In other words, if you squat 500 pounds, I mean, how much weight are you realistically going to do for 3 sets of 5? Like maybe 405, maybe 415, right? We're down probably in that 80% range. So again, I wouldn't really put it there, right? Wouldn't put it there. Again, that's almost hypertrophy, just like 5x5s. I pointed that out years ago. You know, I brought 5x5s back in a little bit for novices. I'm one of the people who was responsible for that with the Ice Cream Fitness 5x5, okay? And a lot of people chatted. I remember Izzy, who I get along with pretty well at Powerlifting to Win, he was asked to review that program. It was a powerlifting program, and he's like, this is a bodybuilding program. This is not a powerlifting program. And he was right. So again, all of that is really falls more of into the category of hypertrophy work with a mild strength element. Whereas when we're talking power building, we are talking about coming in and doing actually low reps, right? Low reps means 1 to 3. Okay, 1 to 3. And then doing bodybuilding work afterwards. But keeping in mind, so little is done that it doesn't impact recovery. In other words, the guys who are doing this successfully look like bodybuilders. I mean, I'm slowly starting to look like one doing this. Because it's not interfering with hypertrophy work. The volumes are kept very, very, very low with low frequencies, meaning you're probably not doing a bench or a squat more than once a week. You're probably not doing a deadlift more than once a week. So again, you're incorporating just enough to get stronger, just enough to develop maximum force production, which is not so dissimilar from, say, what Westside did with conjugate. In a way, I feel like the conjugate method really led to a lot of the evolution of the whole power building type training that you're seeing. Because again, look at the guys who were promoting it, how many of them borrow, incorporate elements from Westside and do it. Yeah, not just me. Not just me, it's like another guy's doing it. Absolutely Westside elements. So in a way, that felt like that kind of pioneered the way to this method. But again, the workloads and volumes are kept very low, just enough to develop that high rate of force production and the skill on these big lifts. And then everything else is bodybuilding work. You know, usually 8+ reps, all the way up to 15s, 20s. Okay, that is the idea behind this. So really, to me, power building is, that's what it is. It's usually a 3 to 5 day bodybuilding split to where you start up to 3 of the workouts with close variations of or of directly the big 3 done for 1 to 3 reps. Very, very low volumes, as little as 1 set, maybe as high as 3 or 4, but you're not really seeing people doing beyond that. And again, you're seeing some guys who do some other stuff, like maybe make it an incline or a reverse grip or whatever. And I think that's perfectly fine. But again, you're seeing some heavy pressing, heavy squatting, heavy pulling in the 1 to 3 rep range. And then you're seeing true bodybuilding work, like training like a bodybuilder for everything else, training in more of a traditional bodybuilder sense, not any sort of hybrid training. It's all just bodybuilding after that, because there's no need to think about, oh, I've got to do some the heavy 5x5 or any of that. That's all being handled by the heavy work. People are just coming in then and like, let's just get jacked after that. So again, it's a great way to get jacked is the primary focus, but still maximize strength. Okay, because guys who are doing this are turning out pretty dang strong, which is what we would expect, because size really does build your strength potential. And you really are kind of incorporating the best of both worlds that way. And I used to say that for a long time before I kind of got into this method is, look, if you want to get strong, you can come in and do training matches followed by 10s, okay? Because then you'll get really jacked and you'll have enough heavy work to develop maxes and to get strong. All right, guys, but that's really all I have to say on that today. I hope it's been informative, and I will talk to you guys and gals next time.